Hi everybody, welcome back to the channel. Today I have Parker Frontier with me. So I'll cover the parts of the pen, what I like, what I don't like, and then we will have writing samples for this pen. And also maybe I'll discuss some potential issues that you can face with this pen that I have already faced. So this is a new pen. This pen does not have any issues actually. So I have a similar pen that I used to use in my college around 15 years back. So this is a pen that I bought in my college time. I wrote well with this pen. I have wrote, you know, many pages with this pen. Still it writes well, but the only problem that I'm facing with this pen is that its cap is loose. You can see here. So what happened was this pen fell down, and it fell down finial first. The finial hit the ground. So when the finial hit the ground, the finial was pressed inside. Due to that, the cap loosened. So you can see in this new pen, the finial is quite raised, and this older pen has the finial tucked into it. Right. And now coming about the, you know, likes and dislikes of this pen. I like the body of the pen, make of the pen. Right. The, you know, weight is very well balanced pen. Then the cap is also very good. The clip is very functional. It says Parker here, right, on the band of the cap. So the other, you know, thing that I don't like about this pen is its nib unit. So I'll open this pen. It has a plastic grip section and a plastic feed, steel nib. And this grip section, or sorry, the nib feed and nib itself, this whole nib unit is Parker proprietary. So if I just pull this out, so it comes out easily. You can see here in the feed, it has these locks, small locks. You can see there are two locks here, and the nib has these grooves. So these grooves help the nib to get locked onto the feed. So when the nib gets locked onto the feed, it does not fall. So this is proprietary to Parker. If your nib breaks, then you have to get a Parker proprietary nib. You cannot replace this nib with any other, you know, Indian or any other Western nibs of number 5 or 4. This is the biggest disadvantage of this pen. If the nib breaks, then you need to get the Parker nibs that are, you know, not usually easy to get. Otherwise, this is a workhorse pen. You can write as much as with it. You know, it won't let you down. The converter takes good amount of ink. You can also fit in a long cartridge to this pen, and then it'll give you even more writing capacity. And I got this pen in gold trims. My older pen was also in gold trims, so I got the new one also in gold trims. You can get this in other variations, like you have this steel pen with chrome trims, and then you can have a black pen with chrome trims and gold trims as well. But all the Parker Frontiers come in steel body. So the size is also decent. If I compare this to Lamy Safari and, you know, Airmail quality J71, you can see J71 is a huge pen, so compared to that it is a small pen. But if you compare it to Lamy, there is no much difference. So in hand also, this pen feels good. It feels good, and you know, the weight is also distributed nicely. So the other disadvantage, or I would say not so good thing about these Parker pens, is that I don't know if I'm wrong about it, I may be wrong about it, they don't have defined nib sizes. So I don't know, I got this and it is almost a broad pen. I have another Parker Frontier. I have two more Parker Frontiers. One has a finer nib and one has a medium nib. So there is no standard on the nibs that you will get. I don't know, you know, it's up to the luck, you know, what nib you get. So let's have some small writing sample onto this. So the pen is Parker Frontier. So you can see here, this Parker has almost a broad, medium broad nib. So ink is Parker itself. So let's write something. The Lazy Dog. So all the Parker Frontiers have very good ink flow. They are wet pens, not very dry, not very wet. They're not gushers, but still they are not very dry itself. Also, they are good. The feed keeps up to the flow, and you can write as much fast as you can with this pen, and it won't skip. It never skips. Then you won't get much line variation onto this, but I don't know what is with this nib. So I have interesting nib here. I am getting some line variation, but otherwise you won't get much line variation onto this because these are steel nibs. Otherwise, for price range of 500 to 600 rupees, or around $8 to $10, you get a workhorse pen which never lets you down. This is a very, very good pen for college students, for office going people who tend to write more with this pen basically. And thank you for watching the video. Please do like the video, share the video, and subscribe to the channel for more interesting videos. Thank you. Bye bye.